spinal muscular atrophy is a genetic condition affecting the neuromuscular system. It basically affects cells in the spinal cord, which are important for survival of our muscles. So these cells are called survival motor neurons, and these cells die over time because of the genetic defect, causing progressive muscle weakness. The most common type, which is spinal muscular atrophy type 1, presents before 6 months of life. And the signs and symptoms to look for would be low muscle tone in a child. So you would see your child is very floppy. Your child will appear weak in terms of a weak cry or a weak sound. There is weakness in the swallowing muscles, so they will have difficulty swallowing and chewing. And typically in type 1 spinal muscular atrophy, these children never learn to sit up. Or if they are developing okay for a few months, they will start regressing pretty fast. There are three more types. So type 2, typically the age of presentation is anywhere between 6 to 18 months of life. These children are typically able to sit up without support, but they never learn to walk. Type 3 spinal muscular atrophy is anywhere from 18 months of life until late childhood, and these children may learn to walk but may have progressive walking difficulties and may need some form of assistive device or a wheelchair eventually. Type 4 spinal muscular atrophy is more of adult onset. Fortunately, now spinal muscular atrophy is a treatable condition. There are three FDA approved medications, and these are disease modifying medications that have been approved. First one being Spinraza, that was approved in 2016. Now with the advent of these FDA approved drugs, there is a lot of hope for these kids to survive well into their childhood and adulthood. There is a lot of hope that these children can regain their functions that they had once lost, because the basic principle of the therapy is to actually help produce that protein that was dying or missing because of the defective gene. So these medications are actually life-altering for our children with spinal muscular atrophy. So spinal muscular atrophy typically does not affect a child's intellect or cognition, and generally these children are very bright personalities. As a parent, if you feel your child is regressing in his or her motor milestones, that means your child was doing certain things and is no more able to do. For example, if your child was sitting up and now is no more able to sit up, or your child was never able to gain a particular milestone like rolling over or sitting up or walking. If your child looks weak and floppy, if your child has difficulties breathing, has difficulties chewing and swallowing, I would certainly see your doctor as soon as possible, because there is a strong window of opportunity to treat these children. And as long as we recognize them and treat them on time, the overall prognosis is very good.